Hello students, in today's video, let us learn about concentrating collectors, especially the focusing type. So in previous videos, we were dealing with different kinds of equipments used for utilizing solar energy, for collecting the solar energy. In all those cases, the instruments are able to produce energy to a little bit extent only. For example, we can get a heated water from these kinds of setups, but the efficiency of these equipments like solar ponds or solar water heaters are very less. When we need large scale of energy production, especially for electricity generation and other similar purposes, we need very high efficiency. So to achieve this requirement, the solar energy must be concentrated using some optical methods. So here in this equipment, we will be using some kinds of solar concentrators that will concentrate large area of sunlight onto a small area using mirrors or lenses. And if this concentrating collector is able to track the sun using some mechanical movement, then efficiency will be automatically high. You know, sun's position will change depending on time, and if there is some movement for the solar concentrator to track the sun, just like a sunflower, it will have very high efficiency. So in this video, we will be focusing on the focusing type of solar concentrators. So basically, there are two different categories of concentrating collectors, which are focusing type and non-focusing type. In focusing type, the solar energy will be focused onto a very small area, and different categories of focusing type of concentrating collectors are parabolic trough reflector, mirror strip reflector, Fresnel lens collector. And in the non-focusing type, we will not be concentrating or focusing the solar light onto a very small area. Here we will deal with flat plate collector with adjustable mirrors and compound parabolic concentrator. So in this video, let us concentrate on focusing type solar collectors, concentrating collectors. So the first one is parabolic trough reflector. It is a line focus system in which a long mirrored concentrator in the shape of a parabolic trough is used to concentrate heat. So as in this figure, this is a parabolic shaped reflector, and the light falling on this reflector will be focused onto a single line. And a fluid is flowing through this central pipe, which is a very special kind of fluid, which can be used for heat exchange. For example, water can be used if temperatures are of low order, but if temperature is high, a suitable heat exchange fluid is to be used. And the outer surface of this tube is coated with a special coating so that maximum energy is absorbed by this pipe and it passes on to the fluid flowing inside the tube. So as you can see, sunlight falling on a very large area is getting concentrated onto a very small area, and hence its efficiency will be very high. So the collector pipe with special coating at its surface is fixed along the focus of the reflector, and the heat is transferred to the heat exchange fluid flowing through the pipe. So that is the mechanism that we will make happen in a parabolic trough reflector. Now the principle of a parabolic trough reflector is that the lines or the rays that are falling on a parabolic reflector after reflection will be focused onto one particular point, the focal point. So this point can be found mathematically considering the shape of the parabola. And if we place any particular object or fluid or solar cell at this point, all the sun rays that are falling or anywhere on this reflector will be focused onto that. So instead of just placing a fluid or solar cell anywhere, if we place the solar cell or fluid at this focal point, it will have very high solar energy being received. India's first solar thermal power plant based on parabolic trough reflector was established in Rajasthan. So as you can see here, these are the parabolic troughs that are covering a large area. And here you can see this tube allows passing of the heat exchanger fluid, and that fluid will get heated up to a very high temperature. Now moving on to the second type, the mirror strip reflector. So it uses a large piece, uses large pieces of mirrors forming a concave surface, thereby reflecting the sunlight by each of these mirror strips to the focal point of the concave surface. These are used because it is not practical to make a parabolic dish of such larger area using a single piece of glass. So since these reflectors cover a large area, it is often impossible to construct a single piece using glass or metal. So often mirror strips are used to form a one reflector. So as you can see in this picture, here many number of small pieces of mirrors are used to achieve the purpose of a parabolic reflector, and these are focusing light onto a single point where we place our instrument or the heat exchange fluid. The mirror strips are arranged close to each other on a metallic frame having concave shape, effectively forming a large concave mirror. The absorber has to be placed at the focus of the dish. So its working is very similar to that of a dish antenna TV, satellite TV receiver. Each of these points will be reflecting signal or the sunlight to the focal point where we place the heat exchange system. Now, the solar power plant at Mount Abu in Rajasthan is a good example of such kind of system. So here you can see each of these dish consists of a large number of mirrors, and they are focusing this light onto a single point. So at this power plant, it generates about 1 megawatt of electricity, and the dish concentrates the solar rays towards the indigenously developed highly efficient cavity receivers, which are positioned in front of each dish to store thermal energy. The iron core storage can be heated up to a maximum of 450 degrees Celsius using this setup, and the heat exchanger coil embedded into the thermal storage medium is used to transfer the heat. So these are the setup that is available in Rajasthan corresponding to mirror strip reflector. Now, power tower design is another peculiar kind of design with this mirror strip reflectors. It is a variant of mirror strip reflector. Here, a large number of individually adjustable mirrors forming the shape of a huge parabolic dish is used. And these mirrors reflect the sunlight onto the top portion of the central tower. So as you can see in this picture, a large number of mirrors that are placed separately are used to concentrate solar energy onto a very high tower. Inside the top region of the tower, fluid is being heated by the concentrated solar radiation, and temperature up to 800 degrees Celsius can be obtained by this method. So here you can see a power tower design where a large number of mirrors are used to concentrate solar radiation onto the top portion of a tower where heat exchange fluid is placed. Now the third type of focusing type solar collector is Fresnel lens collector. And here instead of reflection, we use transmission. This is a transmitting type solar concentrator. Until now, we were trying to reflect the light onto a point. Now we will be using lens to focus the light onto a single point, focal point. So this is a Fresnel lens. And the concentrator is used to focus light for heat generation by placing the light absorber at the focus. Often solar cells are placed at this focal point where a large amount of solar radiation can be concentrated. This Fresnel lens collector can also be used in a reflection mode. Here, instead of this Fresnel lens, in the reflection mode, we will be using a number of Fresnel reflectors, aka similar to our mirror strip reflector. These Fresnel lens, reflectors will be reflecting light onto a single point where the heat absorber or PV cell is placed. So the Fresnel reflector system actually simplifies the parabolic trough design. Instead of using a large single parabolic reflector, in a Fresnel reflector, we can mimic the shape of parabola with a set of flat mirrors. In a mirror strip reflector, we need to place mirrors in a parabolic shape. But here, the parabolic shape is avoided and the reflectors are suitably positioned to get maximum reflection at the one single point. In this picture, you can see a solar power plant based on Fresnel reflector design. Here a large number of mirrors are placed and the light is focused onto a single line where very high solar radiation concentration is obtained. So these are the three different types of focusing type of solar collectors. I hope these concepts are clear for you. And one important thing is that even though investment and the expenditure for such construction of such setups are very high, the benefits that we get from these setups are very high, higher than its expenditure. Sometimes the output that we get from these power plants are very high than that is expected. So our country should try to produce more solar energy using these setups. I hope these portions are clear for you. Thank you.